My story starts overseas. I was working in Eastern Europe and I had pains in my stomach, and I went to a local clinic and nothing, they didn't find anything on an endoscopy or an ultrasound. So I made an appointment to come back home to get a CAT scan. We landed at Columbia because Dr. Chabot seemed like the one that was the most expertise in the field, and Columbia had a pancreas center. So I scheduled the Whipple surgery. When I woke up, I realized that the surgery wasn't complete, and I saw Dr. Chabot and my family. And the one thing that was amazing at that exact moment was Dr. Chabot was holding my hand, which really made a difference when he told me that it was stage 4, that it had spread to my liver. But they had a promising trial here at Columbia with his oncologist, Dr. Manji.
Pancreas cancer is a tough disease to treat, not only because of its aggressiveness, but because of its location. And in order to treat it well, you need physicians from multiple different expertise to really get a multidisciplinary approach.
Pancreatic cancer patients' care has steadily improved over the last 2 decades. The excitement that we feel today is around the potential value of immunotherapy, as well as treatments that are aimed at the unique way that pancreatic cancer cells use energy, so their metabolism.
Immunotherapy basically allows your immune system to attack the tumor. Pancreatic tumors, from what I understand, cloak themselves with healthy tissue so your body and your immune system can't get to it. Dr. Manji in the lab had this theory that there was a way to make it work, and the mice that got the treatment lived much longer than the other mice.
In my laboratory, we gather deeper information on the individual mouse level, performing studies very much in the same way that we perform clinical trials in a hospital, so that we can use it to learn about what's going to happen when we take the same drugs and move them into clinical trials.
In this clinical trial, we treated 11 patients based on the discoveries that we made in the laboratory. And with these 11 patients, we found that 7 of the patients had tumor shrinkage, 3 of them had stable disease, meaning that the tumor did not grow or shrink, and 1 patient had tumor progression. This finding was very promising, and based on that, the clinical trial has now expanded to over 100 patients, which will be randomized to chemotherapy alone, or patients will get chemotherapy in combination with these drugs, and the results will then give us more confidence whether the combination has potential superiority to chemotherapy alone.
Every time I get a scan and I see the tumor shrinking, it's incredible. And Dr. Manji told me, even if it doesn't shrink, as long as it doesn't grow, you're winning. There's a score you get. It's a pancreatic cancer protein in your blood. When I started treatment, it was 700. Under 30 is normal. It's now 6.
There's never been a time where there were more exciting stories emerging from the laboratories, making their way into early stage clinical trials and showing this early signs of success. So I think that we're about to see a sea change in the treatment of pancreatic cancer, both local disease as well as metastatic pancreatic cancer. And I feel incredibly blessed to be part of the generation that gets to work on that problem.